Well, she was my dog, I guess. I got her from, a neighbor. They're not, like, a breeder. But they had a border terrier meet another border terrier, and they were looking to, give away puppies, I guess. And I was lonely. My parents died. But, I guess you know that. They left me a house, but it's fucked up lonely to be the only one living in some dead people's house, you know? I came to their house. Their backyard, really. And they had all the puppies, kind of, you know, all meshed up. I mean, in some, cage. She wasn't the biggest, but I, noticed her right away. She was a bit of a bully. She was playing, yeah, but you got the sense she didn't have patience for the other dogs. They bothered her, and she wanted them to know it. And when I came over, she was the last to come see me. The others, they just jumped up, trying to get me, wanting attention, wanting to be picked up. But she just sat down, and she stared at me for a good bit. I stared back. It was weird, I guess, but I felt like she was sizing me up. She came over, real confident, kind of pushed aside her brothers and sisters, and I held my hand out to her. She clamped down on my hand. But not hard. It wasn't mean. She was never mean. Not to me. And from then, I guess I knew I had to get her. If I thought I was magic, I don't think I would have been a telemarketer. Living in my parents' house. And Maddie? No. Maddie was definitely not, magic. I mean, shit, she was afraid of rainstorms. She thought the vacuum cleaner was a real animal. She was, a smart dog, though. Always seemed to be more person than dog, yeah, but not magic. I always thought, you know, she could learn a bunch of tricks if she wanted, but she clearly had no interest. Mere tricks were beneath her. She carried herself like a little queen. I guess she was normal. I mean, like I said, she wasn't really a big fan of other dogs, but she'd play with them. It was always like, you know, they were beneath her. But she'd chase them. She was, real territorial. Maddie killed a couple, birds and stuff. A squirrel once, because it got caught up in a fence. Never thought she'd ever catch one. Shit, you should have seen her. Blood all over her muzzle. So damn proud of herself, even that was, I guess, sadly normal. I was taking her for a walk. She always loved walks. I mean, shit, I guess all dogs like walks, but she liked them a lot more. I don't know. Maybe that's crazy. But we were walking, near the street, and can we turn up the air conditioning? Just a little bit. A car hit her. I guess I wasn't paying attention. People said I was lucky I didn't get hit, but I'd rather gotten hit. Maybe I wouldn't have died. Skeeshed her down the middle. It was horrible. Person driving the car was some teen girl. Wasn't her fault. I was jaywalking. She was young. Wasn't her fault. I knew her mother. She lived on the street. But I couldn't stop crying. There she was. Waltzing Matilda May. There she fucking was, and she was dead. Bleeding everywhere. I took her in my arms. She wasn't breathing. I didn't get to be there for her last breath. I think she died when I was crying, when I was stunned by all the shit. I took her. I walked her. It wasn't that far. Said I was in shock, but I knew what I was doing. I got a shovel from my garage. My dad's shovel. I got her favorite blanket. Guess it was my blanket, really. A big, green one. She always loved it. It was mine, but it may as well have been hers. She was more comfortable with it than anyone else could have been, you know? You give a dog a blanket, and you swear, no human could ever be so cozy. So I wrapped her up. All broken. God, she was so small. I dug a hole. In the middle of my backyard. There was a spot where the shade of the trees didn't reach. She'd lay there. Waltzing Matilda May I have this dance. That's what I named her after. I was going to kill myself the day I noticed that she was, everywhere dogs were. Just a normal walk. But I was going to, jump off a bridge. I don't know if I really was gonna, to be honest, ma'am. But it felt like I was gonna. It felt right. But things were weird. I never noticed so many border terriers in my life. The neighbors, all of them, identical, and they looked just like Maddie. I thought I was losing it. They were trying to get under the gate, trying to climb up it, barking at me, carrying on. I didn't notice anything was weird until I got near the door.
Good morning, SCP-2420. I've heard you had some trouble sleeping.